Yo, what's good, Yotta Talk? We back with another one. I'm in here with my boy, Chef Sean. How you doing, bro?
Man, I'm all good, man. What's happening?
Chilling. This is new joint, Shake. You can move if you wanna, if you can't or don't wanna, you can skate. I throw this cake if you do that on the handstand. She put a body by the water and did a damn dance. She gave me bands. We ain't friends no more cause she gave me a chance. I got plans just to get back in the pants. But I only wanna do it cause she text me like I can. Hey. Big moves, fuck you thought. That bitch is past since they thinking like a thought. Goofy niggas in the way, but I'm the rock. She make it pop for a nigga when she
Oh, let's go.
She see the check and these diamonds in my necklace. Hey. Take this monster like a pussy, got a death wish.
Yeah.
I got a bitch with a degree that I play chess with. Riding naked on the e-way cause she reckless. I told her, Shake, you can move if you wanna. If you can't or don't wanna, you can skate.
That's that new joint, Shake. Shake, make sure y'all go get that. Check out the new video on YouTube. The YouTube video goes crazy. So let me start way from the beginning, bro. Where you from?
Chicago. Yeah.
What was it like growing up in Chicago for you?
You know, it had its ups and downs. You know, it was rough, but then you make the best out of situations. So
for sure. How long?
At least I did. You know.
Yeah. How long were you in Chicago for?
All the way to adulthood.
Oh, okay. For sure.
Yeah, and then, you know, I had kids and then left.
Okay. Yeah, that's when you decided to get out of the city.
Came out. Yeah, you know, life changed, you know, perspective.
Yeah.
You know, goals and shit, you know.
For sure.
What used to be cool wasn't cool no more, you know.
Yeah.
Stuff like that. So, you know, just took things a little bit more serious.
Yeah.
Felt like, you know, I had better opportunity elsewhere.
Mm-hmm. And I know at a real young age, you actually got into the entertainment industry, like in your teens, like right before your teenage years, right?
Yeah, 13.
So how did that come about? How did that whole process?
Well, I think I was younger than that, you know, maybe.
Well, I remember it was like 11 or 12, I think.
Yeah, I think so. But yeah, I lose track. But yeah, man, that was dope because, you know, that, you know, certain stuff actually came out, you know, I was a kid and things came out, you know. It was different in Chicago, like out in L.A.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's all kind of Disney stars, Nickelodeon stars. You know, different, you know, movie stars.
Yeah.
And they all in the same, all in L.A.
Same circle.
It wasn't like that in Chicago. They wasn't just everywhere. So, you know, I went to a regular high school, you know.
So it made you stand out a lot.
Yeah, it was, you know, it was popping up.
Yeah, for sure. So what was that like? Because I read you actually was working with Janet Jackson.
I'm tripping.
Jada Pinkett Smith.
Yeah, that's poetic justice.
Jada Pinkett Smith.
Yeah, I had the nigga from
I done got high off the heavy hitters. That's my bet.
No trip. But I had the nigga. From Cohart from Crucial Conflict, hey Joey, you the nigga from Poetic Justice, ain't you? nigga, wrong one, but nah, you know I didn't got all kind of stuff.
So, what was that like as a kid being around stars like that?
Oh man, crazy! You know, first person I met was Jada Pinkett.
That was the first person you met.
Yeah, that was when because I didn't know who was, you know, I auditioned for it in Chicago.
Okay.
We filmed it in Houston, so they flew me out. You know, as far as I knew, I was the only person in the movie because, my role, I did the audition on tape.
You didn't do it in person?
Nah, I did it on tape and they sent it out. So I was reading the lines to the camera. Wasn't even reading the lines to nobody.
That's crazy.
Yeah, and they liked the delivery, obviously. So they brought me out, and first person the director introduced me to was Jada Pinkett. You know, and I was already like, damn, she was bad from, you know, young Jada was smacking.
Crazy, yeah.
Yeah, but I was a kid. Like, I was a baby, but I was looking at her like, I'll do something to her, yeah.
For sure. Following that, how long was the acting journey for you?
Like I say, it might have, you know, my mother, she didn't want to bring me out to Hollywood early. Thought I'd be one of the little kind of spaced out Hollywood kids or something. I don't know. But she had her own reservations about it. But she like, you staying in the city. I like, all right, cool. So I stayed in the city and I ended up getting into some other shit. Yeah. So, you know, I just wasn't as focused on it. You know, I was out, you know, got into music. You know, I'm out shooting dice, you know.
Just, doing some hard.
You know, I had a bunch of kids. So
I was
living.
Let's talk about that a little bit. When did you have your first kid?
Shit, I was like 16, 17, maybe.
What was that like?
I was a kid having a kid. So.
And how many kids do you have now?
Now seven.
Seven? Yeah. Seven. Yeah. Fatherhood's crazy. I just had my first.
Get ready. You had boy or girl?
Girl.
Oh, shit. It came right with the heat for you. I had three boys first, so, you know,
yeah, a little easier to take.
Yeah, the girls, man, are different, boy.
Right, it's different for sure. It changed my whole life, yeah. for sure. But let's talk about music. I know you just recently released Shake, but let's go back to when music started for you, because I know you said you got into it after acting, right?
Yeah.
So what made you change paths and go into hip-hop?
I was smoking weed. I was pulling up to auditions, you know. You know, getting out the car, smoking, you know. So I smell like weed in some of the auditions. And this as a kid, you know, like 18, 17.
Yeah.
And it was like my focus was like elsewhere. So I was more like studio. Like in the studio, I got to be myself.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And do, you know, I got to be creative. And
so the acting was more like a job to you?
Yeah, you know, it was definitely a job. I had to portray somebody else or play a role, you know, when music was, I could be myself. So I was comfortable being myself, and so it came easy to me.
It came way more natural then.
Yeah. No, but, you know, acting is like my first, you know, I can act my ass off.
Your first passion.
Yeah, my first passion, but it's, you know, like now I really want to do it more, you know what I'm saying? Because I could see a lot more roles that I could kill now with the, you know.
With all the different shows coming out and shit like that, for sure.
Yeah, but, you know, but as it, when I was coming up then, it was kept trying to give me like the little kid role, you know, the good little kid role. Or the,
yeah.
You know, the bad little kid role, but it was always the little kid role. So I'm like, let me hit the stool.
For the audience, can you name some of the projects that you were a part of? I know we already mentioned the one with Jada Pinkett Smith.
Well, yeah, that was Jason's lyric. Mm-hmm. I did There Are No Children Here with Oprah Winfrey. I was on a episode, well, two episodes of Missing Persons, which was like on ABC.
That's right.
Yeah. Teeth and Blood. I was in Teeth and Blood. I was okay. Mike Hung, you know, some kick-ass detective, you know, fighting vampires, you know, Teeth and Blood.
Yeah.
Yeah. And shout out to, you know, the director and writer of Trenches. I just did Trenches 2 just recently.
Oh, that's hard.
Yeah, so look out for me in that. Coming out soon. Too.
Make sure y'all go check out for that, bro. Hey. And make sure y'all go check out all the movies that he just listed to.
Yeah, definitely go check out that Jason's lyric if you haven't seen it. It's a hood classic.
So, going into the music, what was the very first project you released?
Very first project I released was a song called I'm Sick.
I'm sick.
It was an acronym, SIXTA, for something in Chicago is killing me. So something in Chicago is killing me. But the beat was produced by Kanye.
Yeah.
And that was probably the first thing we did. But
you mentioned so many names already, bro. Yeah. Oprah Winfrey, Kanye, Jada.
Shit. It's funny you brought up Oprah. Oprah again, because on set I gave Oprah my damn business card. I was a kid, like, but I was like, yeah, check this out, take that.
For real?
And yeah, she took it too.
What'd she say?
She said, I can't believe this kid. It's like under her breath, kind of. So.
Yeah, shout out to Oprah, bro. That's crazy. That's stuff we would never hear. So I know you said the difference in acting and music is that music, you get to actually be yourself.
Yeah.
So when you did start to release music, I know sometimes when people change lanes, there can be like a little bit of friction. Did you deal with any of that when you switched over? I know you said you got a beat from Kanye, so it sounds like it wasn't too crazy, but.
Nah, it kind of was organic, you know. But it's funny, it's ironic that now a lot of the entertainers and rappers, you know, they doing more acting than the actors are. It's a lot of acting
Talk
now.
Talk about it.
It's a lot of acting now, but yeah, it ain't too much, you know, being yourself no more, but, you know, they putting on this image. But me, you know, I try to stay to myself.
Yeah. Keep it genuine, though.
That's the only thing that worked for me, you know. Yeah. All the other shit just, it always play out or, you know, it looks bad, you know.
Yeah.
It ain't genuine.
So being someone that grew up in the entertainment world, basically, I know you just mentioned how things have changed. Why and when do you think that happened? Do you think it's because of social media? Like when you say people are just starting to portray images, it's not as real.
I mean, it's been chipping away. It didn't, you know, over. Because you had your few back in the days. It didn't just happen, you know, like, oh, now the new rappers, now there's always some. You know, but the audience is building along with, you know, like, it's not, the audience isn't as big as the artists now. So
yeah.
It's so many artists, you can, like, see so many more of them because it's.
Yeah, that's facts. Especially because of the internet, too. You can see so many of those.
Too many mugs is on the stage and not enough up in the crowd.
That's a quote, bruh. That's a quote. Too many.
Not enough up in the crowd. Hey, everybody want to be the
everybody want to be the star.
Everybody want to be the show.
Yeah. That's facts, though. Because I know nowadays, and we've been in the studio with each other and whatnot, but nowadays, a lot of people who started in the background now are trying to be on the forefront as well.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. So that's crazy to me, too. But I think so.
Pac did it. Pac was in the background, started and, you know, made his way to the front.
I didn't even think about that.
Digital Underground. Because
he was the dancer.
Yeah. Probably one of the first. But he took it to his own level.
That's crazy. Pac did it first.
Yeah. Thinking of Pac, Jada Pinkett introduced me to him.
Oh, you got introduced to Pac?
Yeah. Smoked some licorice joint paper with him.
Stop playing.
Yeah, hiding from my mama. I'm like, fuck that. And then she looking right at me. I'm like, she gonna see me smoke this blunt. I thought it was a blunt because it was brown, but I'm like, what is this? I asked her what it was. He said, it's licorice root, licorice paper.
What?
I was like, oh, shit.
Pac was smoking.
He was like, I looked over, I'm like,
Man, what was that like? I mean, Pac is, words can't explain how big of a legend that he is. What was that like being around him?
It's kind of wild. You know, he was sitting there, he was quiet, but listening to his music and pouring out a 40-ounce.
What?
On the House of Blues floor. That shit was crazy. That was probably one of the craziest nights.
That's crazy. And you were a kid still.
I was a kid. That's why I said I was hiding
for your mom's.
I was like, you know what? If she see it, she just going to have to see this one.
It's Pac.
Yeah.
It's like, Pac. I ain't skipping this one, bro. Your very first song, obviously you started rapping. You said you're going to the studio as you're going to auditions. You released that first joint. How did that come about to where you're like, okay, this is the one I'm releasing?
It was a group.
Okay.
We auditioned for like some show, and we kicked the audition off with I'm Sick.
Okay.
And like, we had the whole place going crazy. Like the people auditioning and everything. They was like, yo.
It's over with, yeah.
Yeah, so we had got the headline on the show, and we like, man, we got to put this out. Because we didn't have it recorded at the time. We just had the live version. You know, we played the beat and did it live and shit.
Every time?
Hell yeah.
So that was like, but you got to see it to hear it.
Yeah, so we ended up laying it down and putting it out. Well, we actually had issues putting it out. That was the main thing. We couldn't clear the Jimi Hendrix sample that he had did. And he wasn't big.
Back then.
We was kids. It was before all that. Like,
yeah. Before Kanye was who Kanye is now type shit.
Yeah, so. And I ain't have, like today I would have got that shit cleared.
Yeah, because you got different resources now.
Yeah, but back then I didn't have a chance.
So back then Kanye was just passing out beats or how was it? He was just like the producer that most of the artists in the area went to.
Oh, no, nah, he wasn't giving them out to everybody. Kanye was in a group called the Go-Getters from Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
The guy that was in the group with me grew up with, you know, the Go-Getters.
In the group with him.
Yeah, they was cousins or some shit like that.
Okay.
So he got the beats from them. And then we went and laid the shit down.
That's hard.
Shout out to Go-Getters. Shout out GLC. GLC was one
GLC
of them.
GLC was a plug.
But, you know, as time went, Kanye blew, you know.
Yeah.
Told Taylor Swift she ain't really win, you know. George Bush don't like black people
on TV, bro. Yeah,
you know.
Kanye still be doing crazy stuff.
And
bro.
The story goes on.
Yeah, for sure. While we're on Kanye, do you think Kanye is like a good representation of how like some of the people in Chicago? Maybe not, obviously not talking about like the off, but just like the passionate upfront vocal.
The talented Kanye, the, you know, the college
graduation,
all that is definitely a great representation of Chicago.
Okay.
Yeah. Shit. That new album that he just dropped, Vultures.
Yeah.
Killer.
Yeah.
Yeah. I listened to it. That is one of his best albums.
Album of the year, I think. Even though it's early, it's super early.
But I don't see too many albums fucking with it.
Yeah.
And then Ty Dolla Sign slid all over that one.
Yeah.
Like they killed that. So yeah, shout out to both of them, man. Vultures is top notch.
So let's talk about the new joint that you have out, Shake.
You said you saw the video.
I did.
So I know you know that's really Shake is what they doing. Shake is what the whole point is. They on that shaker, and you know.
If you wanna, if you don't wanna, you gotta skate.
Yeah, you can skate. You know, skate.
So, was,
really, it's all, you know, just come have some fun with me, you know. It's my interpretation of a good day, a good night, something like that, you know.
Yeah. In general, bro, your catalog is crazy. Like, your views are insane.
Thank you.
On all of your tracks.
Thank you.
Like, I was running through your YouTube, your Spotify, like, crazy.
Yeah, you know, we still building, though, man. Like, I started with, like, 5 spins.
Yeah.
You know, I remember. So, you know, it's a work in progress still. But thank you, though.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, I be liking to know that the hard work pay off. Yeah. And then, you know, last year and, you know, the year before last, last year was, The year before last was like, because you know, yeah, it was all involved in the Grammys. It was the first time. I had a lot going on, man. So you know, just thankful, and hopefully soon be able to win my first Grammy.
Yeah, for sure. Let's talk about that BET performance.
But that was early with Megan Thee Stallion.
Yeah.
That was early, but that was South by Southwest.
South by Southwest.
Yeah.
That was over there.
Yeah.
And you've been to South by Southwest like 20 times, right?
Twice.
Twice?
Yeah, but shit, I did like 20 shows.
You did 20 shows with only going twice?
In the 2 years, like, shit, one year I did probably like 6 shows. The other year I did like 14, probably.
What's performing like for you? Because obviously you grew up in front of the camera. What's the difference from being in front of the camera and being in front of a large crowd?
You can look the crowd right in their face. Mm-hmm. You know, you can interact. You got to act like the camera not there, you know. Certain instances, yeah.
Yeah.
You got your one, every once in a while, you can look at the camera and be like, excuse me while I sop her up, you know what I mean? But for the most part, you got to act like that camera doesn't even exist.
Doesn't exist. Yeah. That's crazy.
And so, then don't get caught slipping, looking at it. Cut! Oh, shit, cut. He looked at the camera.
What is that like being on set with them yelling cut? When they'll do it right in the middle of your take?
Yeah, I mean,
right off?
Especially like if you did something that they had to repeat and tell you not to. I've seen it.
That's crazy. Did that ever happen to you while you were on set?
Yeah, not to me though, but you know, like the little kid I was working with.
Mm-hmm.
What's funny is we were having a hard time with him for like 3 days in a row, and we had a lot of film with him. And one day, it was always bumpy though, so they was always cut, try it again, you know.
Yeah.
And one day he decided to bring his cousin up he brought his cousin up there to be a extra.
Oh, okay.
They looked at the cousin, and the cousin looked just like Bokeem Woodbine, like exactly like him. And they was like, all right, you know what? We're going to still pay you, but, you know, we're going to pay you for your work, but we're not going to use it. We want your cousin.
Yeah.
And his cousin is the one who played Josh, and we had to reshoot. All the stuff we did with him already, which was cool with me because I got extra pay for those days and, you know, time, but I was like, damn, we got to do
all that over again.
It was wild.
That's crazy. What's the longest you've been on set for?
Probably what? A month?
Basically going in a trailer, like going back and forth from set to set.
You know, and then in between, you know, because I was a kid, I still had to have schooling. So I went to school.
How did you do that?
They had tutors and teachers
at the set.
On set. So when I wasn't filming, I had to log in a certain amount of school hours.
So the whole time you were just working, basically.
Yeah. I didn't really get to, you know, enjoy the trailer.
Being out there.
The trailer, I didn't really get to enjoy it because it was like,
Go do your schoolwork.
Yeah.
That's insane. So what's it like going there, being on set, you're with these stars, you're going back and forth, different red carpets, and you're going back to school? Like, what? What is that like? Because you said you just went to the regular school, right?
Yeah. Yeah, but, it was Chicago, so.
Yeah. And I don't mean to jump too far backwards. Yeah, I know, but what was that like?
I mean, one, they didn't know at first because the movie didn't come out.
Because it didn't come out.
So I blended in for a while. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, the movie came out on a Friday. Like, everybody went and saw it Friday night. Monday, back in school, it was cracking. I walked into the school because, you know, the majority black school I went to, you know.
Yeah.
all black movie back then. So
yeah, for sure.
Yeah, all the niggas came. Lil Jason. That shit was crazy.
So when did you make the move out to L.A.?
In 2013. Yeah.
And is that when you were bouncing around from auditions but still doing the studio, or were you more focused on music at that point?
I wasn't really focused on nothing at the time. I was focused on change.
Getting out the city.
Yeah, just getting out the city. Yeah. I was making music, but I wasn't, like, pushing it. Mm-hmm. I was just making it. And when I got out here, I actually started pushing. You know, it was like, all right.
Yeah.
I had to get comfortable, get set first, but once I did, we started pushing.
And when you first did it, were you all on your own at that point? Like when you first came out here?
Yeah.
Or did you already have
something
set in motion?
No, I always had a good support system, man. Al, big dog, he was always here. You know, he always had my back. I used to come out here, you know, get packed sometimes and, split up from some of the people I was with.
Yeah.
Al had to come pick me up, you know. Oh, man. All right, I'll be there. God. Okay. But yeah, he come get me.
So, you coming, though.
Yeah. I one of the reasons that the push started was when I got here, he started, I kind of fell into Chef Sean and Blaze, you know,
okay. Yeah.
A rock band.
Yeah.
That he put together. But
He
put the band together because of a song I did for Teeth and Blood. Mm-hmm. It was like a rock hip hop, like a trap rock type. I did like a rock song for the
movie track.
For the vampire movie. Yeah. And he like, man, let's do a video for it. And he went and got some real rockers.
That's crazy.
To come act like they was doing
the crazy guitar and all that.
Turns out the boys knew how to play. They actually was playing
They wasn't faking.
Yeah, they was actually playing the song instead of like
pretending and just making.
We rocked out, and I was like, man, y'all should do this, you know. And we did it. We started doing shows, and a lot of shows. And I could say that working with Chef Sean and Blaze built my stage performance, built like, you know,
yeah,
the drive, the hunger to really get to the next. Yeah, so shout out Al for that.
What was it like to get love on going in a completely different genre?
I felt like it was my own, you know, which was cool. But every time we performed, it was like, okay, I got these guys, they playing covers pretty much of my old music.
Yeah.
So every time I went out and spit and did
But they're
song,
playing it live.
They're playing it live, but it's like a song I did, you know, it's an old song, and I was just thirsty to give them new chef. Mm-hmm. So eventually the band got dropped, and here we are now.
Yeah.
Shaking with the bitches.
Also, the joint that dropped right before that, Toxic Joint.
Toxic, yeah. And then the one before that it's too late. It's too late, they wish they seen it coming. Hit them with a different stroke, yeah, that Philip Drummond. Yeah, now that Toxic and Too
Late. Yeah, I'm good, they let me in with that thumper. That's that joint.
Yeah, I'm good, yeah, they let me in with the thumper.
Yeah. That's featured with Mac.
With Tucker, yeah, Mac Tucker.
Yeah. That joint crazy. I was listening to that joint in the car on the way over.
Yeah. So, you know, we got some joints, and then I got some joints about to drop, too. I got Never Leave about to drop. Okay. Do a video for that, and then we doing a video for Walk, and then you know, we gonna spend some money on this joint I did called Groom Different. Yeah, so we gonna pretty much show, you know, know, the grooming.
You know. So are you just doing like a whole single run right now?
Yeah. And hopefully, I was thinking by May, but probably close to the end of the year, I'll be dropping a new album.
Okay.
But I'm gonna run y'all, you know, with a bunch of singles, some videos.
So you're dropping all those this year?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm dropping.
So the push is real then?
Yeah, nah, the push is real.
Yeah. That's crazy.
And then, you know what, while we talking about a shout out Killer Mike too, you know, because, what are you, about 52? Hey, 1 hour.
Yeah.
Hey, man, you know, he keeping that shit going.
Yeah. And just one.
But guess what?
But he walked out the wrong way, though.
Yeah, no, I ain't even worried about that. Like, you know, it is what it is, but he straight sweet, you know.
Yeah.
And he did pretty much have, one of the best albums of the year. So.
Yeah, but nobody expected that, though. I don't think.
It was out the blue for me, too. But I think it was well-deserved, though.
For sure. For sure. And I think it sets a good example for all the other artists.
For the future, like, everybody think you maxed out on age and all that shit. Yeah. Man. If the music good, the music good, man.
Yeah, for sure.
You know?
That's just like last year. Nas won.
Yeah. If the music good, man, the music good. Like, you can't deny the music.
Yeah.
Like, you can deny the music if it's not that.
I know most of your concept is towards the females, towards the ladies. How did that style come about for you? Has it just always been kind of your vibe?
Yeah, I mean, it's me.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. I got 7 kids, 5 baby mamas. You know, get along with all of them.
Get along with all of them. Shout out to you,
bro. I hope so. No, shout out to them. At least for the most part, I'm gonna say yeah, I do. But yeah, nah, I just being myself, man. You know, we just left Vegas, so
yeah.
You know, I'm gonna say that and just leave it there.
It was for the Super Bowl. We gonna say that it was for the Super Bowl.
I watched the game. It was entertaining.
For sure.
Shit. Yeah.
So when can we expect these new joints? Walk, groom different. I know you said that's the big one that y'all really gonna plan for.
Yeah, we gonna plan pretty big for that one. But we should see Never Leave real soon.
Never Leave up next.
Yeah,
and then walk.
Walk, and then groom different.
And are these joints like? Cause I know you've done the rock, you've done the hip hop. You've done the whole club. Are these joints, what type of vibe can we expect?
The groom different got a little of the rock to it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Walk is definitely for the ladies, for the streets.
Okay.
You know, she for the streets. Yeah.
Yeah.
And Never Leave is pretty much, you know, what she did. She never left. She never left. She's still there.
Yeah, nah, you be talking your tracks for sure.
And she's still there too. And she's still there too.
Yeah. Gotta put that on the shirt with the little dot dot dot.
Yeah, you know what? I think so.
So tell me, what's your recording process like? You an engineer yourself, right?
Yeah, but I did it. I had my own studio in Chicago for a few years, and I was head engineer in there. I made the CD covers. I made the CD backs. I did all that shit. I couldn't do it too much longer. I had to focus on my music.
Your own music.
Yeah, I got up out that. I didn't even like, you know, recording myself no more. I needed somebody to push the button.
Oh, you don't even record yourself anymore?
No.
So you just completely focus on expressing?
Yeah.
And do you write or do you punch in?
I I try to write as much as I can, and then I go off the vibe. But usually, in my head, I done wrote the first like 8 bars.
Oh, okay. So you write in your head.
Yeah. Like okay. The first 8 bars probably be set already. I go in there because I done heard the beat. Okay, I know how I want to start.
Yeah.
And then I might punch, next couple bars. And then, I might write the last little bit. So it's like, So it all comes together.
End strong.
Yeah, so it all come together. But it's a process, I done came in with a whole verse written. Freestyle the whole verse. It's all a vibe, really.
It just depends on the day.
It's the vibe.
That's what's up, though, because a lot of people, they come in, and for y'all that don't know, shout out to the sponsors, Smoking Heavy Hitters right now.
Yeah, what? You got one?
Yeah, you open
one. Yeah, let me get one.
Light up first.
Let me get one of these.
But yeah, shout out to Heavy Hitters for blessing the podcast.
Yeah, shout out Heavy Hitters.
Smoking the finest, only the finest.
Yeah, tell Heavy Hitters to send me the pack.
We might be able to link that up. We might be able to set that up for sure. Yeah. You heard him, Heavy Hitters. Send the pack. Send the pack.
Yeah, send the pack.
So when you're shooting your videos, I notice you always have a bunch of models. Is it hard working with so many different personalities?
No. I mean, I deal with so many different personalities. I just got to learn to deal, You learn to work with everybody,
Yeah.
You figure out how to figure it out.
Yeah, that's crazy. Yeah.
But it's hard to work with all of them if my girl pop up.
Yeah. You're like, man, there's certain shit I just can't do.
She definitely make it uncomfortable because who are them bitches, and all that shit.
Yeah, for sure.
And then, I just tell her, like, shit, I'm over here working.
Yeah. It is what it is.
Yeah. Let me work.
Let me work. So tell me, what is it like? I know you mentioned baby mama, 7 kids. What's it like being a father while being as entertainer as well, as busy as you are?
Rapping and being a daddy to my little children. I've been spinning. Yeah, that's all it is. Rapping and being a daddy to my little children. And then smoking gas.
Only the fighters.
Yeah, shout out Heavy Hitters. What's up?
Biscotti.
Yeah, I knew it was something.
Biscotti.
I knew it was something. I just smoked with the best of them, goddamn it.
He was smoking with Pac, hey.
The weed wasn't like it was back then. I fucking had that orange hair shit. Yeah, they got orange hair. So, like, oh, yeah, motherfucker.
Wrapped up in a licorice paper.
Yeah.
Yeah, nah, that's crazy, though.
I was young, but I knew what was good and what wasn't.
Yeah.
But hey, I think he had some chronic, though. That was the first time I ever had.
Smoking chronic.
Yeah, I think it was the first time I ever had some chronic. I was like, that shit was,
That shit crazy. I can't imagine smoking with Pac, bro. Not to take it all the way back, but as I'm smoking, I'm just thinking about it. Right over and being like,
yeah.
Hey, you go, Tupac Shakur. Appreciate you.
Yeah.
So do you see any more acting roles for you in the future?
Hell yeah. And nigga, I can act till I'm 90.
I know you're coming out in trenches too, you said.
I'm talking about 10 years from now, 20 years from now.
That's your passion.
I plan to still be acting and doing,
Yeah.
This role to the next, whatever it is. The killer, the whatever the role may be.
Whatever.
Look at Morgan Freeman. He still going.
He do everything.
Yeah, yeah.
He do everything. He like Shaq with the commercials. Yeah. Shaq do every commercial. For people who want to get into acting, what's some advice you can give them coming into an audition?
I could say, make sure you go over your lines. That's probably the best advice. Be prepared. Second, you know, enunciate, you know, make sure you're heard. Third, probably the one of the other things, be sharp enough, like practice your improv skills, you know. Those three, if you do those three things, you should be pretty good.
So you got to be prepared to improvise when you go to the audition.
I mean,
easy.
If you have to, yeah.
That's crazy. So have you ever been in a situation where they just called you out and was like, do A, B, and C? Something that wasn't on anything that you had prepared for.
No, but I had the lines and dropped the paper. I dropped the paper and I kept going. I improvised and I filled the blanks in myself. And they liked it. They liked that, you know, because I stayed right with them.
What role was that for?
Oh, I ain't end up getting it. But they show, it's like, oh my God, that was a nice way to get that shit. I was like, yeah, thank you. Probably why I didn't get the role, but shit.
That's crazy. Nah, but that's good. That's good for people, upcoming people to hear like that. Stuff like that just happens. Because that's something that can make somebody stop. You know what I'm saying? They just get embarrassed and stop. But
it was like three of them, so it was like, you know how the paper hit the wheel, one slip.
Just kept going.
Kept going
strong. I always ask three questions to end the podcast. And I know we over here getting high. But the first one is always, where can they get all of your information, your social media, your music, your merch, your touring information, anything like that?
Well, right here I'm going to say, shout out Brahma Bull, because usually anybody asks me that, I'll be like, man, holla at Brahma Bull. You know, he take care of everything.
It's in his Instagram bio if you don't know. Yeah, Real call, Chef Sean.
Yeah, call Brahma. Hey, Chef, call Brahma. Yeah, I can do it. Call him. Shit, but yeah. The Real Chef Sean on Instagram and music merch. Music, you could just type in Chef Sean and all my shit come up.
Yeah.
But merch, Legal Pothead is a clothing line, a clothing brand that.
Not merch, it's a clothing brand.
Yeah, okay. That I'm a part of. And, you know, I feel strong about, you know, the quality of the clothes and the push behind it. So be looking out, you know. You can look it up right now, Legal Pothead 1 on Instagram. You know, we got some real good models on there, too.
That's a perfect promo while we smoking a little joint.
Yeah, but it's a dope brand, and the quality of the clothes and everything is top-notch. So, you know, give it a look. We got merch right now, different color hoodies, sports, all kind of
everything.
Man,
Legal Pothead, go check them out. And another one we have to ask you: where did the name come from?
Well, Chef.
Chef Sean, yeah.
I cook crack, man. That's where it come from. I cook crack. Yeah. 80s crack.
You know, said I cook 80s crack.
That Rick Ross crack.
That Rick Ross.
Yeah, I cooked that
freeway.
That Franklin Saint crack. Now, you know, it's really It comes from the studio. Remember I said I had a studio in Chicago for a while?
Yeah.
I named, you know, I happened to name my studio The Kitchen. So there's one person in particular that kind of started it, you know. Shout out Dirty Charles. He doing 67 years right now. He probably on year 13, something like that right now. But he used to always come through. He's one of my main clients. He was fighting the double murder. And he'd just be the double murder the year before. Yeah. But this nigga's like, hey, this the kitchen, right? This the kitchen? Well, you the chef then, Chef Sean. Don't you like that? You like that, don't you, Chef Sean? And that's how the I got the name. Yeah, I wasn't gonna tell him different. I was like, all right.
Yeah, shit.
Yeah.
Right, them cases. Yeah, you got it. I'm Chef Sean. You mean I'm Chef
Sean? Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. But shout out Dirty Charles, man. You know.
That's a crazy story, man.
Free that man.
Free Daddy Charles.
Yeah, yeah. This nigga met my mother one day. I leave the studio office to go in the studio. I come back, he in there sitting down with my mother. And he was like, I just gotta beat these murders. I was like, whoa.
What the hell? He said that to you?
I was like, nah, nigga. Nah.
You say, yeah, when we do this.
My mama hold his hand, sitting there like, baby, pray for you. I was like, yeah, we all gonna pray. Pray together. Yeah, yeah, that shit was funny as hell.
Shout out to Daddy Charles.
Yeah, yeah. I was like, how you get to telling that story? That's my mom. Oh, man.
I just gotta beat these murders.
That's what I came in on. I just gotta beat these murders. You know, I'm like, damn it.
For someone in your shoes who has accomplished as much as you have accomplished, worked with as many legends as you've had, from Jada Pinkett to Oprah Winfrey on the acting side to the music side, Kanye West, BET performance, South by Southwest, going to the Grammys, being a part of that. I mean, from someone in your shoes, if you were to look back and talk to the kid who is just taking that first step, what would be some advice you would give to him when it comes to being able to stay in the game? Because so many people fall off, as they say nowadays, or, you know, you just forget about them. But you've been in this entertainment industry your whole more than your working life, since you were a kid. So what would be some advice to that person who was just taking that first step and how to stay in the game long term?
It may be harsh advice, but, you know, just if it's in your heart, stick to it, you know. You may come across some stuff that may, you know, you may want to find a whole new job, you know, start over, you know. Like, fuck this, I got to do something else, you know, I can't do this no more. You know? But if it's in your heart, stick to it, and, you know, it's going to work its way out. But just honestly, you got to stay focused and, you know, if it's what you want, you got to stay after it. Mm. You know, you can't let nothing take you off track. Because, you know, you fall off track, you never get back on. And you don't get nowhere.
That's a call for it right there. You fall off track, you never get back on, you never get nowhere.
Yeah. I swear, you know, once you get content with sitting still and not working. That's what you're going to be doing, not working.
For sure.
You got to work. You got to put the work in. It's not going to just come. You know, you may think you've done enough work, but, you know, it ain't your, you just got to stick it with you. You know, some people get it, you know, overnight, you know, but it's your story is your story. So, you know, you got to make the story, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got to give them something to write and watch. You know, the story has to write itself. And you living is writing that story. So, you know, ain't no story if you just sitting still.
Yeah.
What you going to tell them? Yeah, man, I sat at that table. I was on that couch. Imagine watching that
movie. That's it.
No, imagine watching that movie. Like,
that's it, yeah. You know,
man.
The whole movie.
Yeah. That nigga, he didn't do nothing. He ate. He sure was hungry. you know, just little stuff, man. You got, if you want it, go after it.
Yeah.
You know, if it's in your heart, you know, stick to that.
Yeah.
Because that's the only thing that's going to make you happy.
Yeah. I love that. And I love what you said, too, about you got to give them something to write. Yeah. You know, you got to make your own movie.
Yeah.
You know, like, I love that. That's a great picture for people. Especially the one about Bridget sitting on the couch. But the second part to that question is, after being in the game for so long and, again, accomplishing as much as you have, once you get to that point, for the person who is like, hey, I'm doing this right now, but I kind of want to switch lanes, but they're at that, you know, that little middle ground to where they may not decide to go ahead and do that, even though they're being pulled in that direction, just because they've been doing this one thing for so long.
They just need a little push.
What?
You're saying for the ones that just need a little push.
Yeah, because I know you had to once be at that point when it was going from acting to music, right?
Yeah. Street shit to music. Mm-hmm. Acting, street shit, you know, all that, yeah. Now, you got to go with what's right here. You know, and always, I'm going to say try to make the smart decision all the time. But, you know what the right decision is.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know in your heart what's right. So go with what's right and what makes sense.
And that's what it is.
Yeah.
Chef Sean, I appreciate you coming on Yada Talk.
Man, Yada Talk. Well,
you keep that whole pack. We got some more stuff for you to pick out over there, too.
What, this right here?
Yeah.
Yeah. Good looking.
For sure, for sure.
And then shout out OK Deezy. You know, go download his music. And then it's a hard-ass battle rapper out there. His name K-Venom. You know, if y'all ain't hip, you know, hip yourself.
If y'all ain't hip, hip yourself. Yeah. Chef Sean again, thank you. Make sure y'all go check him out. Real Chef Sean again, thank you. Peace.
Moves, fuck you thought. That bitch is past tense, they thinking like a thought. Goofy niggas in the way, but I'm the rock.